Hey again, everybody, welcome back. And in this video, we're going to add our decorative supports to our little office structure here. On the previous video, we did our main support beams here that you see. And in this video, we're gonna add some decorative supports across the bottom and the top up here, just to give it a little bit more of an interesting look. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Before we do that though, I realized that we hadn't touched our level lighting yet. So my level might look a little bit different than yours. That's because in between videos, I was playing with the lighting a little bit to kind of get a better look for our level. So let's go ahead and do that together really quickly. Go ahead and click the light source here, the little sun icon. And over in the details panel, we have the intensity and light color. We're gonna change both of those. My light color is expanded, but you can expand that just by clicking this little drop down here. So we could click this little bar here and that will open up the color picker where we can kind of toy around and see what kind of lighting we want. You know, we could do whatever we want. But for us, we're gonna punch in some values. So we're gonna set the R to 255 and the green to 218 and the blue to 182. And we're also gonna bump the intensity up to 10. Now, these are just the values that I was experimenting with. You can kind of play with whatever you're most happy with. Let's click build so we get an updated preview. And once that builds, there we go. There is our more warm and inviting office structure. So I'm happy with that. Hopefully you guys are too. If not, like I said, you can kind of play with it and get a lighting that you are happy with. So let's continue. Let's add our support, our decorative supports. So we're going to go over to the content browser and props, and we're going to drag in the SM pillar frame. So I'm just dragging and dropping that in. And we're going to add this along the bottom down here. So go ahead and grab this green arrow, drag it up against the wall, and drag this one over into the corner, like so. You may notice as I fly in, it gets a little bit brighter. That's because we still have our working light attached to the camera here. Let's actually disable that because it's kind of bright in here now. I don't know that we need it anymore. So I'm going to go up to this little drop down here and lock viewport to actor, unlock from our point light. And there's our little light. So I'm going to click on it and hit delete. We don't need it anymore. And looking at our pillar, we can see it's kind of big, so we're going to have to scale that down. Let's make sure it's up against the wall first, which it looks like it is. That's good enough. And for our scale, let's go ahead and hit R to go into the scale mode. Let's change our snap value and bump that down to 0.06 here. And then let's grab this blue part of the widget and drag it down. So there we go, that fits pretty nicely into that spot. Let's hit W to go back to our move tool, and then hold Alt and drag a copy to the other side, like so. So there we go, we have one in each corner. We're gonna eyeball these additional ones that we're gonna add. We're gonna add one about here and about here. We could do some fine tuning and get precise, evenly spaced pillars, but for our purposes, we're just gonna eyeball it. So I'm gonna hold Alt and drag a copy out to about there. I'm gonna hold Alt again and drag a copy out to about there. Pull back a little bit and look at it. Let's just move this one over a little bit and this one over a little bit and this one over a little bit this way. There we go, good enough, good enough. Feel free to get an evenly spaced measurement if you'd like, but for our purposes, that is good enough. Okay, we're gonna add some to this side. However, I don't want to add four. I'm just gonna add some manually, a couple of them. So let's select this one here. I'm gonna hold Alt, drag one into this corner over here. Make sure it's in the corner, like so. Looks good. I'm also gonna place one on this beam here. So I'm gonna hold Alt, drag one out to about there. Looks like it's in the middle. Now it is. So that's good. And let's add one more right there. So I'm gonna hold Alt, drag this out to the center, and then drag it up against the wall here. So that looks good. I'm gonna be a little bit nitpicky here. Probably can't notice it too well because it's kind of dark here and we killed our light. But if I fly over to one of these, I guess, you can kind of see it a little bit better. There are some grooves in the top of our pillar here. Let me just rotate this one to show you. I'm going to select it and press E. and then rotate it in. See these little groove things here? On this one, I want those facing out into the open space here instead of looking at the back of it. So let me rotate that back just like that. The other ones I don't care about, but this one I'm just going to be really super critical about and rotate it around 180 degrees. And you can't even see it yet, but once our lighting comes in, then it'll be a little bit more apparent. So I move it up against the wall. Again, you didn't have to do that, but I chose to. And there you go. We have some across our bottom floor here. Let's add some across the top here. I just pressed E to go up and down, Q and E to go up and down. And let's select this one and hold Alt and drag it up. And it is, let's see, on the floor there. Clips into the roof a little bit, but that's fine. We're not going to keep this position. Let's move this into the corner, like so. Let's actually change the scale of this, actually, just a little bit. Give it a little bit different vibe up here. Make them a little bit skinnier. Instead of one scale of one, let's drop these down to 0.8 and 0.8. Just a little bit skinnier, because we're going to add more of them up here anyway. Make sure it is in our corner here. That's close enough. Again, we're going to eyeball these. We're not going to do exact measurements, so I'm going to hold Alt and drag one out to about there. Gonna drag another one out to about there. I am releasing Alt each time and then pressing Alt again to drag out copies. So I'm gonna drag, there's four, and there is five. So that looks good. It's not quite lined up with this bottom pillar, but again, for our purposes, that's fine. Gonna hold Control and select each of these. And then with Control still held, I'm gonna press G to group them so that we have a group of them. And then we're going to hold Alt and drag out a copy, and then hold Shift to move our camera with us and make sure that it is in our corner. So that looks pretty good, actually. We have a little bit of a space in here, but it kind of breaks it up with this pillar, so I'm happy with that. You can add one there if you want. For our purposes, it is fine. Let's add some to the other side here. So I'm going to select this group and hold Alt and drag it across to this side, and let's just move it over a little bit so that it is kind of centered on this wall. And with that selected, I'm going to press E to go into rotation and then hold Alt and drag this arc over so that it is 90 degrees, then press W to go back to the move tool and move this one up against this wall. Like so, something like this. So there we go. That looks close enough. Let's just move it over just a little bit. Close enough. Looks pretty good to me. So we are going to add some along this pillar, some along this pillar, some along this wall, and some along this wall. Looking at this wall, actually, I kind of want to change this wall material so that it matches the other ones now that I look at it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that really quickly. You don't have to. You can leave it like that if you'd like. Brings up a quick time to show you another quick shortcut here. If I select this pillar and I go to the Details panel, currently we are looking at props in the content browser, but if I select this pillar and I go to the Material inside the Details panel, it is using that wall texture that I want. So if I click this magnifying glass, that will jump me right to it, and then I can quickly place it on the wall. So I could have went into materials as well. I could have found my materials folder, which I'm already in, but could have went to it and tried to locate it. But just a quicker way of hopping to things inside your content browser. Again, here's our pillars in the details panel. Here's the static mesh. I can click that magnifying glass and boom, jumps me right to it. So I can start placing more again. Just a quick shortcut. So with this back group selected, I'm going to hold Alt and let's fly up a little bit. Hold Alt and drag out a copy to the center here, like so, so that it is in the middle of these pillars. Looks pretty good. I'm going to press E to go into rotation mode and hold Alt and rotate a copy 90 degrees. Then press W and move these along this pillar. This is the point in the video where you could easily skip ahead or pause if you'd like. Once you get the gist of these placing these pillars, you could probably skip ahead if you'd like. So with that, I'm just going to continue and finish it off because we're almost done. So with these, let's hold Alt and drag these across like so. That's pretty good. Good enough. And let's press E to go into rotation mode. Hold Alt and rotate those 90 degrees. Then W to go to the Move tool. Move these up against this wall here like so. Let's bring them actually into our play space. And make sure that they are on the floor or on the pillar. I'm being really critical right now, but that's good to me. That looks good. So there we go. We have a bunch of pillars inside of our little office area, and it's really starting to come together. This middle section is where we are going to add our glass partition. So we're not going to add any pillars there. So for the sake of this video, I guess we can wrap up here. And in the next video, we will start building our glass. Hope to see you guys in that video.